We're on number 16 of the solutions to the intermediate algebra practice problems for midterm 1. If p of x equals 3x squared minus 7, q of x equals 4x plus 5, and r of x equals x squared plus 2x, part A says find p of negative 4. So we have to look at the function for p of x up here, and it says 3x squared minus 7, so we're going to replace the x with a negative 4. Okay, now be careful. You must put the negative 4 in parentheses since you're squaring it. And then remember what that means, a negative 4 squared. It means negative 4 times negative 4 minus 7. So you could think of this as 3 times 16 or negative 12 times negative 4. It's going to be positive 48 minus 7. And 48 minus 7 is 41. So that's the answer. Part B says to find q of m minus 5. So this time we look up at the function q up here. Q of x is 4x plus 5, and we are going to replace x with m minus 5. So we have 4 instead of x. We're replacing this x with m minus 5. But I still have plus 5. So you see 4x plus 5. But instead of x, I'm writing m minus 5. So now I just do the distributive property and simplify by combining like terms. And that's our answer. 4m minus 15. Part C says q of x times r of x. Well, we replace q of x with 4x plus 5, because that's what it says, q of x equals 4x plus 5, times r of x, and it says r of x is x squared plus 2x. So this is just the product of two binomials. I could use the FOIL method. 4x times x squared is 4x cubed. And 4x times 2x is 8x squared. Inner, 5 times x squared. And the last, 5 times 2x. And then combine our like terms to get 4x cubed plus 13x squared plus 10x. And there we have q of x times r of x. Part D says r of x plus h. All right, this is the trickier one. What we have to do is replace x with an x plus h. So every x here, you see, for r of x, you're going to have to plug in an x plus h. So instead of writing x squared, we'll have x plus h squared. And instead of an x, we'll have an x plus h. Now we have to simplify this. Remember, x plus h squared means x plus h times x plus h. And that's not equals. Say plus sign. And I could go ahead and do my distributive property now or later. And let's do the FOIL method here. You have x squared plus xh plus xh plus h squared plus 2x plus 2h. And let's see, there's only two like terms. The xh, remember that's 1xh plus 1xh. So the final answer is x squared plus 2xh plus h squared plus 2x plus 2h. Now, of course, if you know the formula for squaring a binomial, x plus h squared is x squared plus 2xh plus h squared. You don't have to show these two steps in the middle. Just did that as a little review so that you didn't write x squared plus h squared, which is a common mistake. All right, for number 17, we're asked to graph the piecewise function defined by f of x equals negative 2x if x is less than or equal to negative 1, And f of x equals 3x plus 2 if x is greater than negative 1. So what this does is basically it just kind of part of the graph to the left of x equals negative 1. Now, here's x is negative 1 right here. So basically to the left of it, it looks like y equals negative 2x. It's going to look like a line. It's going to look like a half line. And then to the right is the other one. Now, what I find easy to do is plug in what it's equal to right at negative 1. That's sort of your starting point. So if we look at f of x equals negative 2x, let's just plug in f of negative 1. All right, if you plug in negative 1, that gives you 2. So negative 1, 2 is an ordered pair on this line. Now, we know 0, 0 is on the line also, correct? But the problem is we don't want any numbers to the right of negative 1. So basically, we want to graph the line y equals negative 2x, but this is the furthest point to the right. So if I wanted to get another point, I could pick another number to the left, like negative 2, or you could use the slope idea and get some more points. But basically, that's actually equal to negative 1, so there's a dot here, and now I just draw my graph going up from that point. Now, if you would have graphed the whole line y equals negative 2x, it would go through 0, 0, then you'd have to erase the rest of it. All right, so it's really, you know, it really would go all the way through normally when you draw a line. Now, the next part is f of x equals 3x plus 2 if x is greater than negative 1. So we know there's not going to be a dot when you plug in negative 1, but there will be a circle. So I could do the same thing. I'm going to see when f of x is 3x plus 2, if I plug in f of negative 1, that gives you negative 3 plus 2. It gives you negative 1. Right? So negative 1, negative 1 is going to be a circle right here. So that's sort of like the end of that half line. And then this is really, think of this as a line, right? Y equals 3x plus 2, where the slope is 3 and the y-intercept is 2. So you know the y-intercept is going to be up here still. Or you could plug in 0 to figure that out. Put in 0 for x. And there you have the other part. So there's our function, the piecewise function, using that definition. So if you graphed just both lines separately, you would have to sort of, you know, like if you had actually graphed all this, you'd have to erase that part where I'm dotting it. And the same thing over here, you would have had to erase the part that's dotted because I don't want that part of the line. So if you did the vertical line test, no matter where you are, you're really only going through one value. There's only one y for each x. This is a challenging problem, but what you want to do is just look at it and carefully think, what would it look like if it was the whole thing? I know that that looks like y equals negative 2x would be a line, so it's only part of a line, and the same thing for the second one. So at least if they're both lines, it's not too difficult to do. And then my hint is, where the break point is, this negative one, plug that in for each of them to sort of get your starting point.